Good morning, students. Welcome you all. As we have started the political science chapter, power sharing, we discussed about it that what is the more important concept about the power sharing. We are going to discuss it now. In the previous video, we have seen that what is the position, ethnic composition in Belgium and in Sri Lanka. Now we'll look after that. We have seen that which type of language and which type of peoples are living in the Belgium and in Sri Lanka. Now we'll look after which government is there and how they are working. Today we'll go with the example of Sri Lanka. We'll look after how Sri Lanka works within the form of majoritarianism. Okay, we'll look after what conditions it created in Sri Lanka. Through that, the Sinha is the one who was able to make their supremacy and dominating the Tamils. Children, first of all, you should make it clear that Sri Lanka emerged as an independent country in 1948. One mark question answer may it will be asked to you when it is emerged as an independent country, that is in 1948. After that, children, you should have to look after the next we read about the ethnic composition of Sinhala and of Tamils. We have seen in Sri Lanka, Sinhala peoples are there and Tamil peoples are there. In Tamil, we have seen the native Tamils and Indian Tamils. Now, according to the government which is adopted in Sri Lanka, there is the thing that they adopted democratic form of government. Last year we discussed about it that the better form of government is democratic form of government. So here, when it's declared as an independent country in 1948, so children, in Sri Lanka they adopted democratic form of government. Under these things, they adopted the policy of majoritarianism, where it means that the which who will get more votes, that party will lead as ruling party. So if you remember, in the last video only we discussed about that the Sinhala majoritarianism. It means that who is going to lead, children? Sinhala. The next thing is that now when they lead it, if the Sinhals leading or any community is leading, that doesn't matter. But if they try to do dominating the other party, that time it creates a problem. The same it happens when Sinhal came in force and when they hold held the government, all policies, the first thing they did it that they declared, they passed an act of official language. Which language is called as official language at that time? Sinhal language. That is in 1956, they declared Sinhal language as a official language. These children here, the daughter, this year, 1956. Up till now, we discussed two dates. That is, first I told you about 1948, when Sri Lanka emerged as an independent country. Second date, we are talking about 1956, when Sri Lanka, in that date, they declared Sinhala as a official language. Now, as these date 1956 official language declared, now who will face problem? Who will feel themselves as an alien in their own country? Don't you think Tamils? Now, when Sinhala declared in 1956 as official language, so these Tamils, they felt themselves that we are the alien in our country. Not only this, after that, the next thing they did it, the Sinhala government did it, that whatever government places are there, the university positions are there, that position they filled with the people, those who were speaking Sinhala language speakers. So university position and government job also given to the, especially to the people, those who are belonging from the Sinhala communities. Again, we are able to see that here the problem is there of what? They are not getting equal treatment. They are here, Tamils are able to feel it, this thing that the Sinhala is the one who are trying to dominate us, and they want that the Tamils should have to work according to Sinhala's. So here, Tamils came to know about it that whatever government policy is introduced by these Sinhala community, that is only in the favor of Sinhala community, not for the Tamils, Christians or other people, those who were living at that place. Second thing, what they were doing? Not only this, the next we are able to see that they were very sensitive. Sensitive means what they want. They were very sensitive towards their language and culture. That should be officialized. That language should be lead. That culture should be lead. This is what the concept of Sinhala's. So Sinhala is the one, what they were doing it, very sensitive, and the leader were always in the favor that they wanted to publish, they wanted to foster Buddhism. They want that the people, those who are living in Sri Lanka, they should have to follow only Buddhism. Why? This we are able to see in India, secularism is there. But here under the majoritarianism, they are following this thing that they were dominating the people that go with the Buddhism or foster the Buddhism. Next, these Tamils were feeling themselves alien. They felt it that if in this regard the supremacy will be there of Sinhala, so sure in some future Sinhala will not let us to do any work or will not be in the favor of any other community. So for that reason we are able to see that as more policies, program, government job, this everything was in the favor of Sinhala community. Because of that, the relationship between Sinhala and Tamils is go worse day by day. This has created a lot of disputes and problematic situation in Tamil, in Sri Lanka, where now Tamil feels that we won't be able to silence and listen the government policies as it is not for the welfare of all beings, should have to act. So here we are able to see that these Tamils, what they did it, political organizations were formed. And when they formed it, they demanded that Tamils constraint, they demanded for the Tamil state should be formed. Tamil state should be formed and Tamil Elam, it's called as Tamil Elam, is formed. So children, these organization, now next date, please keep it in your mind, that is by 1980, several political organizations were formed, and where they demanded, under this political organization, they were demanding for Tamil state separate. Why they were demanding it? Because as they were living in the country, which country is not in the favor of all public, those who are belonging from that country, here the Tamils were feeling it that the day will come that sure this enhance will remove us from the our country, or may they will make us they will create this type of situation where this enhance will create a situation that we should have to leave our country. So better before that only, why can't we raise our point? Why we won't be able to make our political organization that they framed and they demanded that we want separate Tamil states where we will live in peace. So as they demanded, this demand will be accepted? No. Sinhala community majoritarianism was there. So because of this, we are able to see the next point, which is I told you, relationship between Sinhala and Tamils worse day by day. Because of that, the situation creates civil war. So children, you know that when civil war is there, when people mentally disturb, so that country's social, cultural, economic, every concept disturbed. The development bar which we are talking, it should be increased, that will start to decrease. We'll read in the economic chapter what was the condition of Sri Lanka, which was quite developed, but because of this internal dispute of civil war, it has created economic crisis in Sri Lanka. So we are able to see that this happens from till 2009 this dispute was continuing, and because of that economic crisis created in Sri Lanka. So children, what do you think that this type of government is good? This type of community should be there who should lead under the process of majoritarianism. We will look after another example of Belgium, where we come to know that same government, democratic form of government, but how they have given equal weightage. We have seen today the example of Sri Lanka, where we are able to see that the majoritarianism policy followed, and because of that the Tamil community faced a lot, and because of this internal disputes, lot of civil war created the problem like social, economic and cultural. This is what affected the country, and this civil war was continued till 2009. Just recall these dates. I told you Sri Lanka emerged an independent country in 1948. Done. Next, Sinhala language. This act, official language act, passed in 1956. Next, by 1980, the Tamil community, they formed, they framed political organization, they formed for demand of separate Tamil Elam or the state. This civil war continued, ended in the year 2009 because of that economic crisis arises in the Sri Lanka, and it affects from all the concepts and development like social, economic and cultural. So children, through this topic we are able to get that whether the democratic form of government is better, but if the government follows the majoritarianism, then it created the problem. Hope you have understood this concept. In the next video, we'll look after the accommodation in Belgium. Thank you.